Morning, everybody. This is my daily practice of calligraphy streamed live on YouTube. If you are in my online class, you can meet me there to raise your questions other than calligraphy. So it will be live chat plus calligraphy with a video demo. I could also do other demos later if needed. If no nothing requested, I will just practice my routine. So as yesterday I talked about the copy book I got from my grandfather. And did a little bit the first page of that yesterday. So I'm going to continue this. By the way, it's very important to repeat the same routine over again until you can memorize it. To save time, I don't grind my ink. I use some overnight ink in my car. Is not really overnight. It's from the ink cake, the solid ink, plus some liquid ink. This way I can get the ink paste. I need to soak my brush. My water here. So I soak the brush, and you need a paper towel to dry it. So it's not with any extra moisture. If you are new to Chinese calligraphy or painting, I like to show you how do I hold the brush. Just like how do you hold the chopstick. If you hold it correctly, it will function better. So you grab the brush with your thumb and index finger and the middle finger, like so. So you can, if needed, you can twist it to change side. Say if the brush bent this way, you can adjust it. And I have a video on painting. You can also adjust the hair in the middle of the stroke. Let me load the brush. Okay, the ring finger, put behind the brush handle with the small finger. So the middle finger actually serves the could be used to twist the brush if needed. Some school of calligrapher, they prefer not to twist the brush handle. Instead, they use the wrist more. So you will see them doing this and that, or this and this. They will lean the brush handle. I'm not familiar with that, but I study. So you can, lean to the left and lean to the right. So I would do more with my fingers. So I twist the brush. You see, like I can do some little circles when I change directions. You can also use your wave your wrist, but everybody would use the wrist. So you can draw your circles like this. if your wrist is fixed, you have to use your arm. If you do larger characters, you use your arm and shoulder. I think it's all involved, even your foot. So you have to mobilize your whole body from bottom of your feet up to the back. So you straighten your back when you write, and hold the brush right in front of your nose. It's very important to start a stroke and end the stroke correctly, so you don't just draw a dead line, a life or vital line with chi has this. Bone, flesh, and the muscle, So the reason we start, how we start a stroke and end a stroke is because they're all connected between strokes. Like if I write a character, number two or number three lines. So there's connection of qi movement. In the beginning, you might practice the stroke separately, and then you should do the whole character. So every stroke, my teacher, my calligraphy teacher, when I studied, tell me simply just put a pass, a dot. And then a dot to end. Dot, lift a little bit, and then press again. Dot. Okay, I need to see if anybody watching in my class. You can do some preparation or get your brush out and follow me if you will. I just let my students know that I'm online, so we can chat in the classroom as well. Let me repeat the first page we did yesterday. The brush I use is Wang Xizhi, WANG, Wang Xizhi, XIZHI. This is the name of a famous Chinese calligrapher in the 4th century, I think, or 5th century, Jing Dynasty. His most famous piece is the Orchid Pavilion preface. So this brush is designed to write that kind of calligraphy. It might be too small for this, but I think it should be okay. Let me try. It's a little stiff than the combination brush I used yesterday. You should be able to master the natural spring, you know, the resilience of the hair, so you don't have to spend your, you know, what we call the energy. It's a skill to use the spring of the brush to write instead of, you know, struggle with the soft hair. Even the soft brush, like a sheep hair brush, has the spring. And it requires more skill to master a soft brush than a stiff brush. So, you know, a stiff brush is also hard to tame sometimes. It's a personal preference sometimes to use a softer brush or stiffer brush. A stiff brush, you have to write faster sometimes with the spring. This first character has no meaning here, just the beginning of a sentence. This character means the paper. The paper. Like to be, you know, is. I have problem with this radical. Better? Don't know. See, I go down, I go left before I turn to the right. I go up before I go down. And always turn back at the end of the stroke. Sometimes the tip of the brush goes all the way to the bottom and then turn. Sometimes you can stop right there with the like a broken stroke. This all depends. Goes back, adjust the direction, and kick up. This is a little tricky part. It says the paper is like battlefield for battle. I use less ink so I can kind of adjust my brush. If the ink stone is, you know, with too much water, I just do it and it lit. I kind of press the brush, press the extra ink out while I twist left and right and pull to straighten it. If too much ink, you can do this on the edge of the palette or ink stone. This is the bamboo radicle. Remember that bamboo leaf? This character I'm writing is B, a brush. It's like a hand holding a brush handle. Here's the brush. Brush. You kind of swing with your notice the connection between all the strokes. You're not supposed to twist the brush hair. But that's why I do one to left and right when I pour like this, and then I straighten it to a point. Press and then at the bottom, turn back up, adjust the direction and kick. This character means knife, big knife, the weapon. I'm not going to answer calls. I have an answering machine. There are too many advertisement calls. This character, I'm not sure if it's the, the cover of the knife or a different weapon like the spear. But anyway, this word means weapon. The brush is like a weapon. The ink. The ink would be, these days would be like the ammunition, right? Ink is like the armed soldiers. This is a difficult one to fit in the square. So you can write thinner strokes. if you have a dot and go up and then click, and this is all connected. It's very important to keep the flow. This thought is really very fundamental. You need to practice. Notice the angle is not a perfect square. And the straight line is actually a little wave, you know, not exactly perfect straight. But you don't have to pursue that. Just keep it straight, I think, when you just begin. It is said that if the same character appears in the same work, you need to vary them. You know, I tried, but it's hard. Okay. That's all for today. I hope you have enjoyed this daily practice. If you keep doing this, you know, one page per day, you'll see your progress over time. Don't try to do it to 100 pages a day and then stop for a month or a year. That won't help. So you need to practice routinely, okay? If you like to learn more, you can join us on ChineseBrushPainting.ning.com. I'll put the link there. And subscribe to my YouTube channel to follow me with free lessons. Have a great day. Let me see if there's any question. I hand up. Thank you. Okay, thank you everybody on YouTube for watching, and see you tomorrow.